We do want to get to another major story that we're following for you. It's still unfolding as we speak. There's been another assassination attempt against former President Donald Trump. And according to the FBI, it happened yesterday while he was playing golf at his club in West Palm Beach. A suspect was quickly detained. He's been identified as 58-year-old Ryan Wesley Routh. The Associated Press reports he recently moved to Hawaii from North Carolina and appeared to be a former Trump supporter.
Security is limited to the areas that the Secret Service deems possible. So I would imagine that the next time he comes at a golf course, there'll probably be a little more people around the perimeter. But the Secret Service did exactly what they should have done. They provided exactly what the protection should have been, and their agent did a fantastic job.
Well, it's not clear how Routh knew of Trump's location. Sunday's round of golf was not on his public schedule. The FBI and Secret Service are handling this investigation. Steve?
So naturally, many people are on edge after this apparent second assassination attempt, with leaders on both sides of the aisle calling for the former president to receive enhanced Secret Service protection. Let's bring in national security analyst and retired Navy Captain Armin Kurdian to weigh in. What do you think about that? As far as the way that Secret Service is now, typically the bulk of their protection would go toward those who are currently in office, maybe not formerly in office. With now a second attempt, should that change?
Absolutely. And we've been saying this for a while. Good morning, Steve. Donald Trump and Kamala Harris, one of them is going to be the next president of the United States. So for all intents and purposes, they should be treated as if they were the president of the United States. The same for the current president of the United States requires that amount of protection. You said something very interesting in the narrative there as to how this guy knew that Trump was actually going to be playing there. I think that's very, very interesting. Perhaps he's just saw the motorcade and knows that Trump likes that golf course, and perhaps he was scoping it out. So there's a lot of questions yet to be answered. Again, we're very, very lucky and very fortunate that at least this guy was not able to be successful in his quest. But we got to figure this out, and he needs to get more protection. We can't keep having this happen anymore.
And that was my question, is when it comes to the protection, when you have someone like the former president who does like to golf a lot, and I know that's been a question in the past from some security analysts as to how do you protect someone when they're on, you know, a course that does have access to others. You're not living in a bubble here. How do you best protect somebody like that, especially now that we've seen what looks like two attempts in the last couple of months?
Well, obviously, a golf course is very large. Not being a golfer myself, you're talking about, maybe a couple of square miles of area that need to be protected. It's very fortunate that the Secret Service was able to, go out in front and find where this guy was just by happenstance, just by that random searching of all those areas in front. But frankly, you just need to have more bodies. When you aren't exactly sure about the threat and you have these lone actors who don't necessarily have the social media presence in the sense of, there's no chatter. There's no guy maybe just woke up in the morning and says, hey, I'm going to go take this guy out. You don't have any foreknowledge of it's happening. The only way to really prevent that is from having a greater presence on deck. So, again, lucky that he didn't get through. But this is the kind of thing where without that luck of being able to find that rifle barrel that he might have got through, might have been missed. So you just need to have more bodies, and local police presence are the way you got to supplant that. Secret Service has got to do a better job of having more folks on site.
So many questions that are out there right now. Armin Kurdian, thank you very much for joining us, and we'll talk to you again real soon, I'm sure. And in the meantime, we'll see if Congress introduces anything this week to try to get more Secret Service, more official protection for a candidate and a former president, not just the current president. Thanks, Armin. Let's get to Jacqueline.
You bet, Steve.